Hey everybody, Gutter and Birder, we're here with another one of the worst movies on YouTube. And this is the third week of Back to School September, and boy, how the mighty have fallen. I was feeling great after the last 2 weeks of fucking episodes. You know, we had Malibu High and Hell High. Everything was looking great.
At first, that's how the students feel. You know, everything was looking great. Now that it's all settled in, they're like,
fuck. You had to meet your dickbag fucking classmates in his ghoul school. Because that is what we have done. 1990s ghoul school.
Yeah.
Written and directed by the dude that did The Basement. And we have reviewed The Basement back in the fucking day, so if you want, you can always go back and watch a movie made by the same guy that we actually enjoyed more than this one.
Oh, yeah. I think that one had less Jackie, that's why.
And no, not Jackie Chan.
No.
Or Jackie Mason.
No, not any of the good Jackies. The worst of all the Jackies.
Well, we'll get into him whenever his time fucking comes, right? Because it starts off with these obviously newer credits. Like, the credits were obviously made 10 years, 15 years...
later.
After this movie was fucking made. And then it opens up on this fucking drunk janitor trying to hide his money in a box, you know,
right.
Lock boxy wall.
You guys ever seen that video of that drunk dude going to a convenience store and he's just fucking leaning back? He's all over the place.
Yeah.
That's basically what the fat guy was.
Well, because, you know, he puts his money in there and then he fucking stumbles around his fucking little janitor fucking cave. Why do janitors in movies and schools always have, like, boiler room fucking caves where they live?
I know. Don't they have homes? Do they provide them that luxury?
And then we cut to this home where we have these two nerds eating
so little you gotta live right by the boiler.
Eating breakfast when their brother mother's boyfriend, this guy with, you know, just comes in and starts giving them fucking shit, like hardcore fucking shit.
Why don't you faggots get on your way out to school and go learn the golden?
No, faggot! You are too a faggot. You've always been a faggot. You'll always be a faggot.
Come on, man. Yeah, why don't you get out of here, man?
Let's go, Steve.
Oh,
like, I'm really fucking hurt by your actions. Look. I feel like I just made out with you.
Like, I feel like if we're going to play it, it's going to get something YouTube-y's going to fucking happen to us.
YouTube-y's going to happen.
It's going to hear those words, and it's going to be like, wah!
Yeah, but we heard those words. Cousin said it, everybody said it.
You know what, dude? Day. I'm done. Movie's over. Review's over. No, I fucking wish. Oh, this was a fucking chore. So whatever, it cuts to this fucking... So, it cuts to the class where the two nerds are in class reading fucking Fangoria.
Yeah, and you're like,
I can't fucking do
like,
it, dude.
The acting was so bad.
Yeah. Well, because a lot of it was dubbed as well. So, I mean, not all of this movie was fucking dubbed, but a lot of it was.
But it did hurt me.
In
many ways. Like, here they come down the hall. Oh, no.
Well, the principal comes in over top with announcements saying who won the Battle of the Band so they can play at the dance.
All right, now, I'm sure you all want to hear the results of last week's Battle of the Bands contest to decide which group will perform this Saturday night at the school dance. Though I question your taste in music, it's your decision. So the winner is Blood Sucking Ghouls. They will be performing at the dance tomorrow night. It will begin at 7:30, and everyone is encouraged to attend. And no drinking. I'll be there. If I catch anyone drinking or smoking any pots, they will be expelled on the spot.
Right, and nobody gave a fuck.
I don't give a fuck. You don't give a fuck. Nobody gives a fuck.
First off, this band.
We don't even see the band yet, because first we see these two punks pull up on Tom Cruise's fucking bike from fucking Top Gun.
Dude, and we both thought, we were like, here comes like some dude and chick, and now, not two dudes.
And they talk about robbing the fucking janitor and getting back at the principal and all that fucking stuff.
Yeah, these guys were on a mission.
You sure that shit's in there, right?
Yeah, I'm sure. I mean, unless that fucking shithead janitor's moved it, it should be in the wall somewhere. Cool. How come you never graduated, you shithole? Fucking jerk-off principal that's jerking us off over the loudspeaker? You screwed me over. Like to rip his fucking face off. Fuck. After we take down the janitor, you have enough money to buy the fucking phone.
Now we get to meet the van as they pull up in their Astro van.
Nice.
And they get out of the Astro van in all their 1990 glory. Dude, they're all fucking perfect. Like, the band is the best part of this movie. Because, you know, you got the band's girlfriends with their hair that's, like, so fucking high.
Dude, it's fine.
And then you have the lead singer that looks like Sylvester Stallone and Richard Lewis were mashed together in a trash compactor and pooped out the other fucking side.
Pretty much.
And then these the rest of the guys are just... Because look at that dude with the fucking bandana with his fucking poofy. Fuck
dude,
you.
Everybody has... wonderful mullets. Epic mullets. I mean,
there's
was
a lot of mullets
town.
In this fucking movie.
There was a lot of mullets.
Mainly the basketball team, but we'll get into them in a fucking
little
bit.
They were the mullets, I think.
So the school ends, and we get Kmart Return of the Living Dead music.
And we also get a couple other ones. Everything sounds
everything's a ripoff in this fucking movie, you know, I just lost my pen. So, we cut to the principal calling dude, like Joe Franklin, he's some kind of New Jersey personality or whatever.
Listen, I just wanted to thank you for speaking at the school assembly this morning.
Don't mention it, it was my pleasure, Bob. They were great kids, beautiful kids, every one of them. Great, great kids.
But, you know, the principal's talking to him, and it really doesn't matter. What does matter is fucking Jackie, the fucking joke man, Martling, comes in. And we get a whole long-ass, poorly edited fucking scene of Jackie doing awful Jackie, the joke man, Martling fucking jokes.
A girl walks out of the bathroom, her mother's making a cake. She says, Mommy, can I lick the bowl? And her mother says, why don't you just flush it like everybody else? You know when you know you're really lonely?
When?
Your own tongue starts to feel good in your mouth.
Basically, Jackie plugged himself, as Jackie would certainly do. And certainly did. Now we know why Howard hated him.
So we cut to the two punks, and they're interrogating the janitor about the monies.
Now tell me where it is while you still can.
Yeah, tell where it is before we blow your fucking brains out.
Fuck you! Fuck this. Are you sure it's here?
Yeah, I'm sure. It's in the wall somewhere. He's had it down here for years, the bastard.
Watch. I'll find it myself.
And then Unibrow fucking shoots him. So the two punks go into this other fucking room, hit a switch, and get gassed? I don't see no gas. But they kind of return to the Living Dead.
Well, they reacted to something. They were and they just dropped.
And then we get another scene that's kind of reminiscent of Return of the Living Dead, is we're following all these pipes through the fucking school.
Yeah, for a minute.
Like how they were following the rain in Return of the Living Dead, and the music was going and stuff. So until we finally see the water coming out of a drinking fountain and the school's pool.
Pool school. Right. I don't think you can screw that up. School pool. Pool school.
So blah blah fucking blah. Now we get the fucking nerds and they're at their locker and they're talking about having movie night at the school and stuff. And they're talking about like this VHS tape and gore and all that stuff.
The fuck, man? Where is it?
It's movie time.
Cool. Let's go up to the AV room. I want to see some good gore.
The AV room? Are you sure we could get busted?
Kaplan catches us.
That old bastard won't catch us. Don't worry about it. Besides, have they ever gotten us busted?
No,
fault.
Okay, but I hope we don't get in trouble. Trust me.
Oh, just wait. Wait till we get to see what movie they have fucking done. But anyway.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Like, so, do you regularly have, like movie night at the school?
Oh,
you can do that?
So, we cut to the punks waking up and leaving all sickly.
And it was kind of like that. It was, you know, like, and what was that one they were trying to do?
What?
Return of the Living Dead.
Oh, well, yeah, except for they didn't have, like, the cool scenes, period.
No, I know.
Or anything. Yeah, but yeah, I mean, that's kind of what happened in Return of the Living Dead. They woke up, but they weren't, like, that fucked up that quickly.
No.
It took a little bit of time for them to get all fucked up.
Right.
So, but whatever, we cut to the swim coaches, right?
He's getting his time down real good.
He certainly is. We should do really well tonight.
Well? We're going to do better than just well. We're gonna kick their butts.
You better not let them hear you talk like that.
Awesome. You know, you got, like, chick in her fucking awful blonde fucking wig.
Dude, it was a helmet. But, like, I love dudes' fucking, shorts. Basie's balls are an inch away from hanging out.
And then the swim team comes out all fucking ghoul schooled up, all zombified, but they have, like, demon teeth.
They have piranha teeth.
And they all attack the fucking swim coaches, so and it's awful and great.
Zombies.
All at the same time.
Oh my god!
I think they're putting a little bit too much chlorine in the pool.
So they're piranha zombies. That's what they should have named this movie. Piranha zombies, because they initially came from the pool. You know?
Here's the best part of the movie.
What?
Honestly, the best part of the movie. You know,
because
it cuts straight to the band.
Oh, shit.
Pause. Play. And they're playing for fucking ever. We keep waiting. We're like, come on. Where's the fucking lyrics? Where are the fucking lyrics?
None.
Not fucking one.
No. There's a microphone there, but...
We just get them playing to their three girlfriends. And then they fucking stop, right? Yeah. And the band's all hyped up about their performance.
Yeah.
We were great, yeah!
Guys, fucking testing, man.
Woo!
We're fucking brain test tomorrow.
Fucking A right, man.
We still got no words for this shit, but whatever, yeah!
So, Richard Lewis fucking... So, Sylvester... So, Sylvester Stallone, Richard Lewis, and rocks his conversation about business.
You know I think you're the best goddamn lead singer in New York, but we've got to make a change.
What kind of change?
I think I should start managing the band. Don't give me that look. We've talked about this before, and you know it's the best thing. You have a big heart, but you don't have a head for business and strategy, and I do.
Yeah, and what are the guys going to think when I tell them all this?
They'll be thanking you when you start playing big clubs and get a record contract.
Oh, and you think you can do all that?
Yeah, I think I can. I'm pretty tough when I have to be.
And then we cut to the nerds watching their movie, and it's goddamn Robot Ninja.
That's fucking beautiful. This is great. I told you. Crazy Tommy really knows his gore. How'd he get this? It's not even out yet.
it's a bootleg. I gotta get a copy.
Fucking robot that still the worst vigilante on the face of the fucking planet.
Yeah, well, you know, he's trying. You know, he's a very poor vigilante. He's not like Bruce Wayne.
So now we cut to dudes with mullets playing basketball.
Yes.
And then getting yelled at by their fucking basketball coach.
Before we get started with the layup, Jules, I have something to say to you girls. Your performance Monday night against McQuanah High was pathetic. You should have kicked their butts. You're better than they are. We are never going to make it to the States playing the way we did on Monday. Tell you the truth, I almost wish I was home watching the Giants game.
I wish you were home too, coach.
David. Fuck. Diamond Dallas Pino. Diamond Dave.
Yes, David Diamond. Diamond Day. DB Duba.
Who is it, dude?
Jesus
it's
Christ.
It's Kmart.
It's Coach Diamond Dave. Cock. And he's all like, hey, you guys. And sometimes he'll even speak English. He's like, Brooklyn, bang-a-ling, ding-bum-boo. You know, I don't know what the fuck he is.
And then we get many layups. Many layups
that don't go so well. But, like, so Coach was like, so I came in here to motivate you by saying, you guys suck, you know? And, like, but then you show me how, you know, how you're going to get better by sucking more, you know? Good job. So I just walk out of that. I just quit as coach.
So we cut to the secretary's leaving for the day when the one secretary hears a band. She likes it so much, she says all this.
That's the band for Kimono's Bands.
I know. They sound good.
They like that stuff, huh?
Sure. I mean, you don't like rock and roll, Lois? I like rock and roll all right, but that's a little bit too loud for me.
Well, I think I'm going to go check it out for a little while.
Not me. I have to get home and make dinner and see what my little darlings have destroyed today.
Sounds like fun.
It's more like Nightmare on Elm Street. Well, I'll see you on Monday then.
Yeah, have a good weekend.
Thanks. You too.
Bye.
I know, I like the ones like, you like this stuff? She's like, yeah, I could get down with that.
So she goes to watch the band.
Fucking just same riff. Over and over, I can tell that.
So we cut back to the nerds, and they're still watching Robot Ninja.
Nerd.
When nerd number one has to go take a piss, so he goes to the bathroom. And once in the bathroom, he opens up the stall door to find a chick eating a fucking leg.
Right.
Here.
Oh, shit!
Like it was a ham bone.
And then he runs out the hall, and then the swim team all attacks him.
Right. He got away though.
Yeah.
He was running down the hall and shit. He got back to his friend, and the greatest acting on the planet happens right here when these two fuckers converse.
Here.
The fuck is going on?
They're coming.
Who's coming?
The swim team.
So what do they want with you?
I think they want to eat me.
Funny.
No, I'm serious. These monsters attacked me. One of them was eating a leg.
A leg?
Yeah. It was Miss Lloyd.
Bullshit. Holy shit.
That's them.
The swim team?
I think they're putting too much chlorine in the pool.
Come on!
And then one
they're
of us...
coming down the hallway? Yeah, they're coming right now.
And then one of the zombies gets attracted by Robot Ninja, grabs a TV.
Yeah, we're not sure what.
And
what
the, gets electric.
Hits it and gets it and puts his slime hands on it. It was like, you know. So word to the wise, don't get your slime hands on your television. Quick way to die.
So the nerds go open up a locker, find some weapons, and
oh,
guess
don't
what?
Ever watch Robot Zombie yet. Or Ninja, whatever the fuck that was called.
It's fire drill time.
It's time for a fire drill.
And then you know, one of the swim team zombies come up and they fucking clock her in the head with like a million jump cuts.
Yeah, big time. Like I was like, wait a minute, did he hit her once? Because I was like,
and then they ax her and it's all reminiscent of Evil Dead. You know, with like the shadow of the axe and
right,
stuff.
Right.
Isn't that Mary Beth Allen? Yep. This kind of shit just doesn't happen around here. This kind of shit doesn't happen anywhere. What are we gonna do? We can help. Fast. First, I'm gonna check out the pool. Come on.
So blah blah fucking blah, skipping over multiple scenes of fucking bullshit. The nerds run into the principal's office, you know, to tell him about the zombies and all that fucking bullshit.
You don't understand, sir. We've got a real horror story on our hands.
A horror story?
That's right, sir. Mary Beth Allen, Miss Lloyd's leg, and we just stick an axe in her chest.
What the hell are you talking about? Are you on drugs, son?
Listen to me! There are these things in the school killing people and eating them!
And just what are these things?
The swim team.
The swim team?
Yeah, the swim team.
Get out of my office right now.
We're not fucking around here, goddammit. We need to get help. We gotta call the cops.
Are you totally insane? You barge into my office telling me some crazy stories about things eating people, and you expect to use my phone?
It's an emergency.
Emergency? Your grade point averages are an emergency.
Of course, you know, he doesn't fucking believe him and all that stuff.
No, he was quite belligerent. So, all of a sudden, what was the actor you were talking about? What? That one kid looked like?
What, the one kid look like Alex Winters?
Alex Winters, right.
From that's Bill and Ted? Right. From the side, only from the side.
You're making another one, you know.
Yes, I'm aware. So blah blah fucking blah, the nerds decide they have to go back for the VHS tape of Robot Ninja.
Hey, I gotta get the tape. Are you nuts? We gotta get out of here and get help. Those things will kill you. Crazy Tommy will kill me if I don't bring that tape back. Fuck you. Okay, but after that, we're getting out of here.
You give your life for Robot Ninja, you deserve die.
But so they made it to the room, but they can't get it, so they just fucking dip out anyway.
Hurry up and get the tape and turn the other one off. You're stuck. Forget it. Let's bolt.
So basically that whole scene was totally fucking pointless.
Yeah. You know what's terrible is that Keanu Reeves shaves his face and looks younger than me and he's like twice my age.
He's not twice your age. He'd be like 80. So
I don't know math.
We cut to these two fucking face smashers, though.
Smush kissers.
Yeah, rah, rah, rah. And they're all in the wood shop or whatever, and they get attacked by the swim team. And dude gets axed in the dick.
Right in the dick. Like, that zombie was out for vengeance right there. You know, you don't ever go for the dick.
So blah blah fucking blah, the nerds are just about outside when they decide, we should go back for the band.
Wait a minute. What? We can't leave yet. Are you fucking crazy? We're out of here. Those things are still in there. So let's go get some help. By the time it gets back here, they'll be dead. We have to warn them. We have to get them out. Who? Get who out? I hope you don't mean Kaplan. No, not him. The band, man. The band. The band. Shit.
Fuck, dude with his all fucking slack lip looking like Bill Murray from fucking Caddyshack.
Seriously. I'd be like, fuck that fucking band. They don't even have lyrics.
So we finally cut back to the basketball team and the dude with the mullet and the Pizza 46 fucking t-shirt advertising in this fucking movie has to go get a lost ball.
Lots of Jackie the Joke Man marketing.
That too, because there's a lot of shirts that say I stopped Jackie the Joke Man. So,
every time you see that right there,
mullet man goes to get the ball, but his head flies in return.
Take a look at this.
And in come the two punks. They come in all blue and zombified as well.
I'm sure Jackie's somewhere working at a Walmart greeting people, or probably just, you know, pricing shit.
Jesus Christ. What are these guys?
What now, Coach?
And so they kill some of the basketball team. While Coach Diamond David Dickensis runs out with Butnick.
Butt-nick.
Oh, that dude's fucking hair, if it was red, man, is he'd have Butt-nick's hairstyle, and you have no clue who that is.
I have no idea what you're fucking talking about.
Hey, dude. Hey, dude from... Oh, no, not hey, dude. Salute Your Shorts, Nickelodeon, back in the fucking day.
Yeah, I have no idea.
Okay, whatever. Moving on.
Nobody else does.
Yeah, that's fine. So, Coach Diamond Dave and Butt-nick runs into the nerds, and they talk for fucking ever.
Let's kill some zombies on MTV.
These things aren't human. We can't fight them.
We're not gonna fight. Not if we can avoid it.
You don't know what you're getting into here. I do. I'm older than you. I'm a teacher.
You're also a dick.
You better watch your mouth, son, or you're getting detention on Monday.
Detention on Monday? You're worse than Kaplan. I got news for you, Dick. The forecast for tomorrow doesn't look good, let alone Monday.
You little punk.
Back off, Dick. Dick. I think Craven's brain has flown to Looty World for the night. What do you think, Dick?
God damn it, stop calling me Dick.
Oh.
Did you see him lately?
Yes.
He's like, gee. He's like, I've been coked out for so long, gee. I don't know how to stop making this face.
So, blah, blah, fucking blah, the principal gets killed off in first-person perspective.
God damn kids.
And then blah,
yeah,
blah.
Good riddance. Principal was a cack.
Yeah, whatever. I wish they would all die. So, blah, blah, fucking blah, the group runs from the swim team.
Right, again. You know, and there's about a billion, I don't know if we said this or not, there's about a billion chlorine references as to why they're zombies.
Well, there's lots of chlorine jokes.
I want to put my fist through the fucking thing. I'm sure Jackie probably wrote most of it. That fucking cunt.
So, Butt-nick gets got. Blah, blah, fucking blah. The group and the band are in the auditorium now and they're nailing the fucking door shut and they get one of the swim team in the eye.
Yeah. Jackie was,
that was
so
interesting.
Much all over this thing, you know, posters everywhere, people wearing
shirts.
The t-shirts and
yeah,
shit.
Stickers.
Surprised, like, the zombies weren't called Martlings, you know, like, yeah. Oh, no! Whee!
So the cops show up, go into the school.
What do you think? Looks quiet. Wait a minute.
What the hell is that?
I don't know.
They get attacked and killed by the swim team. Blah blah fucking blah. Roxy decides he's gonna climb through the vents.
So who's going?
I am.
Really?
No, she's not.
Why not?
Because.
Well, that's a good reason.
You don't have to go. One of us will.
Yeah, it could get real hairy in there.
Cut the bullshit. You guys don't want me to go because I'm a woman? Well, fuck that shit. I'm the only choice. We need you here to take on those ghouls in case they break through. And I don't think Vicky and Crystal are up to it. Besides, I'm almost out of cigarettes.
Those things are going to kill you, Rox.
Yeah, I'm going to give them up one of these days. Maybe tomorrow.
That happens. Fucking blah again, the punks and the swim team bust in and start, like, you know, killing some people.
Yeah.
The coach, Diamond Dallas The coach gets
bang!
The coach gets bit in the fucking head.
Right. For like a minute, like she was not on that thing.
And then Stallone Lewis, he's getting, like, you know, attacked. We're thinking, oh, they're gonna get Stallone Lewis, and then he hammers
zombie giving him a lap dance. After that, like after they were all done, they were walking past, and he had like a broken lip nerd with him, and he's like, oh, you need to kill him. So fucking Alex Winter's lookalike went down and had to shoot the other. Well, I think he shot fucking Coach Diamond.
I don't fucking know, dude. That doesn't matter because there's some gut eating, a zombie eating guts, and one of the nerds shoots him in the hand. and he dies. Fucking worst zombie ever.
Yeah.
And then we cut to the exact same shots of rocks in the vents that we saw earlier. That's supposed to be different shots, but they're not.
You know, like the one doctor in the one zombie movie. What was his name? I think it was Don. Was it Day or Don? Which one was the one where they were like down?
Day.
In the fucking Day. Okay.
Don was at Monroeville Mall.
Right. Okay. So Day, they were down there. So okay, doctor is trying to.
Frankenstein.
Right. Frankenstein was trying to fucking basically. I don't
know. Tame zombies.
In a way, yeah. So, like, what would happen if it actually worked out for him, in a sense? And Bub just wasn't the only one. But they still like were zombies.
It'd be like that movie Fido. There was a movie that was kind of that.
Oh. Well, Simpsons did it. I don't care.
It was but a pretty good movie.
Everybody's done everything. But yeah, I'm just saying, it'd just be funny. Because, like, they'd be still, like, they'd be really normal lives, but they'd be like, oh, honey, I brought those pig guts home to cook. they throw with some sauce. They'd, like, they'd be like zombie cooking shows and shit.
Rachel fucking Ray Gordon with Ramsay. With her massive. Like,
bouncing around, a little salt, a little pepper, a little butter. You know, have you ever seen how much butter that fucker uses? God damn! He's like a little butter, and he's like, dot, 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 dot. And he's big ass fucking cute.
Well, butter is great.
Jesus Christ, a little bit of butter, goddamn.
Makes the medicine go down.
Does it?
But anyway, we cut to shooting another zombie in front of a Diet Coke machine.
I don't believe Diet Coke had anything to do with this movie, nor would want it.
And then we cut to Rox finally getting to the roof. As she sees, the whole city is fucked up.
Oh my god. The whole fucking city.
Well, we can't see
it. Yeah, obviously, we don't fucking see it. She sees it.
She's like, oh no, it's the whole city is unaware of this taking place.
So, the rest of the survivors leave the fucking school.
Right.
And they get shot and nuked.
Well, because she was like, "Nee!"
Here.
Oh, Jesus.
And nuked.
I'm pretty sure they nuked it at the end. I'm pretty sure they returned a living
like,
dead nuked
sound
it.
Like they
yeah.
nuked them, but why?
And then we get credits and this awful fucking music. So yeah, that was Ghoul School. Nowhere close to as fucking fun as Malibu High or Hell High.
That was a disappointment.
So yeah,
bleh.
Only 1 week left, I think, in Back to School September, so let's hope it's a good one.
Yeah.
Or it's most likely going to be crap.
Probably.
On that note, for Gutter Bird, this has been another one of the... We'll see you later.
I'm going to stop plugging YouTube by saying YouTube anymore. I'm just going to say, worst movies on. Yeah. You're going to take all our money, I'm going to pull my dick out. Not plugging your ass anymore. Worst movies on.
I don't think they need us to plug them, dude. People are just watching it.
I know.
Our stuff on there.
It does not matter.
Ask me how fat she was. How fat she was. No, say, how fat was she?
How fat was she?
She was so fat that when she forgot a diaphragm, they used a hubcap.
That is good.
A guy's in bed with a girl. He says, you're flat and you're tight. She says, get off my back.
Oh, here we go. Steelers.
Urg.
Hold on a second.
I'm fine with that. The longer we can put off talking about this, the fucking better.
I love you.
Yeah, me too, babe.
Do you want your history notebook?
Nah, I don't need it.
What are we gonna do tonight?
Well, I thought we'd go over Danny's later.
Danny's again?
Yeah.
Well, I thought we'd spend some time alone tonight and not go out with the guys.
We are going to spend some time alone together.
When?
Right now.
I'm, like, not here.
Come on.
I'm going to wait for you to do that now. Fuck!
Jesus Christ, what are you fucking Arnold crashing through the window? Yeah, there you go. Get it out. Get it all out. Get the shakes and the tremors and the quakes and the fucks and the dicks.
I don't feel so good. That's why I called you. I want to say I don't feel so hot right now. What might have been in that water?
Just water, Joe. We bottled it ourselves. There's a natural spring in the boiler room.
Bob, it occurs to me, I ran into these two kids named Steve and Jeff. Yeah, Steve and Jeff. You think that they might have put something into that water? I'm a little bit curious about that. Yeah.
Those two guys, Steve and Jeff, they've been a pain in my ass all year.
Well, you could really maybe do me one very definite, specific favor and check out what was in that water, because I'll tell you a funny thing. I feel funny. Yeah, Bob, do check it out for me. Very important.
Okay. Take care. Bye, Joe.
Oh, I'm feeling very, very peculiar. Very, very something.